But what's going on, everybody? I am the one, the only, the W-O-O-K-I-E. Still a little under the weather. I'm still all snuffly and snotly, and it's gross. I have my box of tissue next to me. And for those of you wondering where we went, we didn't really go anywhere. I'm just sick. I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired. And then I went on a family vacation sick.
Where'd you go?
We went to the Dells. We went to Wisconsin Dells. So for those of you wondering,
we did
an episode. I didn't get it up because I was starting. So y'all remember when we had like, it was like 80 degrees and then it dropped 58 degrees like in the matter of 4 hours?
Every other Tuesday around here.
Well, yeah, I was going to say that didn't happen here, but you guys were in.
Yeah, it happened here. So it was like literally like I even brought a sweater with me that night because I was like, literally, it was like 78 degrees outside. I'm not kidding you, Dryascore. This legitimately happened. It was 78 degrees outside, right? Sun is shining. It's absolutely gorgeous. It's like, oh, man, spring broke. Literally, we dropped. So it was like 58 degrees and snowed all within 4 hours.
Mm.
These are real things that happen in Wisconsin. To go from 80 to snowing in the matter of a handful of hours. So that means my sinuses felt like trash. They all dumped on me, and I just felt like garbage. So I made it through. We went to Wisconsin Dells. We stayed at Mount Olympus, did the indoor water park, the outside. There's a couple outside things. Some go-karts were available. We had some fun on the go-karts. Went to the indoor park. Had some fun there. It was all good stuff. But I was still sick, and then I came right back into my job's inventory, and I'm ill. It just didn't happen. So if you're listening to this episode, go back and listen to the last episode, because you probably missed that one, too, because I suck at my job.
Well, we're going to get... By the time they're listening to this, they probably have already listened to the one you're talking about.
Maybe not. If not, go back and listen to it again. It was a good episode, if I remember correctly. Yeah. It was a pretty good episode. Yeah. I don't remember what we went into, but it was a good episode.
It was the second half of Geistoid, right?
Was it? It probably was. I honestly don't remember. But this week, we're talking OP. We're going to do more of a Help from Future Self style episode. 30 minutes. And we're going to cut it off just as the going gets good.
We'll see.
do you like Sealed Dryascore?
Click.
Yeah. Oh, that's gonna do it for us this week and Help from Future Self. But we do have OP kind of news, not really new news, but store champs are going on. Sheep, we did a store champ at our locals. How was our store champs?
Our store champ was fantastic, if under attended.
Yep. So how we have what four? Well, okay. So let's preface this.
Well, one of the only shops that I know of are doing all three formats. We're doing an Archon, an Alliance, and a Sealed. All of them on Tuesday nights. So we're just, instead of our weekly events, we're just charging a bunch of money and handing out a few prizes.
Yay! Bunch of money, a few prizes.
Excitingly, and not even upon our request, our store did order two store championship kits. So
we have two store championship prizes.
Nice.
Now, I got to say, I've gotten a little look-see, right? I'm not thrilled with what's in the box, right?
I think the price for what's in the box is pretty good.
Okay. I mean, you get, is it 12 decks in the box?
Six.
Six decks? Oh, only really six?
Six.
Okay.
Yep.
Well, you get six
decks, three sets of keys, which are the same keys we've gotten many times before.
So not overly excited there.
But technically they were only ever really released during the very first month of Keyforge. So
I feel like they were so in abundance.
They were fairly plentiful, but if you weren't around then, there was a set that sold on eBay for $75 in January. So
you would like to buy my old keys for $75 a crack.
You could have mine for 50 instead.
45 over here. 45.
I'm going down to 45. I have so many. Like The old, let's be honest. Okay, so the metal keys are super nice.
If you sell your metal keys, you're going to pay me because you're using my metal keys. So.
What do you mean?
those 19 keys you have.
You gave those to me.
Yeah, so I'm just saying, if you sell your other keys because you're replaced with those keys, they're all mine.
So I used to be really big into, like, and that was, I'm still really big. Like, I like the keys. Like, I like the different styles of keys. You know, I've got the, what was it? Is it the 2019 Vault Tour keys?
Was that the 2019 Prime
keys. Prime? Well, the small ones were for the Prime, but then they had the
19 Vaults, the big ones.
Yeah, they still had the big ones. I like those. I like the big metal keys. I even have a set of the cardboard ones. I'm not going to lie to nobody. I only have the discs, though. I don't have all the houses. And then I forgot. I had another set. I got the big ones, I got the big 19 ones, and I got the little 19 ones. This is just, it's an area where I feel like they could do so much more with. But if you don't have big metal keys.
Yeah. They are cool, right? Like there are definitely local folks that don't have them, right? The folks that go out to Vault Tours and all that, right? They've got
already upgraded from them.
Yeah.
And gave them to their friends.
But there are definitely so my first store champ event is tomorrow, and I'm hoping a few of these folks come, but there's definitely some folks who I know don't have the cool metal keys who will be excited to win those. So
at least somebody's excited for it, and I'm happy for those people.
Yeah.
Because I've got multiple copies of those.
Yeah, I've got a bunch too, right? I've got those. I got the vault keys. I've got the luxury playstyle ones. I've got
I got rid of
burger
too.
Token ones.
I have the Whoppers too. I like the Whoppers.
Yeah, I've got all sorts. So
I'm down. I just have my 2020 littles, and that's it.
Okay.
Listen to this motherfucker.
Everything else has been
littles.
That's right. I still have the original Vault Tour keys, I suppose. They're in a box somewhere. But in addition to three sets of keys, so six decks, three sets of keys, it's 24 pictures of a tree. And let me tell you, I hate freaking trees, man. I've heard me talk about it before, but all my friends are like, let's go hiking, we can look at trees. And I'm like, okay, one tree, two trees, too many trees.
You like camping and stuff, Sheath. You don't like trees?
Three trees. Wait, have we seen that tree before?
You want to just like, you like camping on like asphalt in the middle of a parking lot? Like, what do you, what?
Fire, food, and beer.
In like a Walmart parking lot. That you don't want trees around you while you're doing that.
I like camping too. We go camping quite often, but a tree is a tree is a tree. Like there's
Man. Like I don't mind if there's trees. I just don't care. Like I'm not like, let's go to the trees. You know what was cool? We went out west and we saw some rocks. Rocks are better than trees.
Rocks over trees. Okay.
Anyways, we got 24 pictures of trees. So you can wood your deck or whatever it is you do with them.
Uh-huh.
And they're okay. Like they're similar quality as the old train tracker keys, so they're a nice enough piece of cardboard for what they are. They're fine, right? And it's everybody gets one, so it's okay. There's nothing great. There's nothing wrong. $50 gets you six premium print decks, which say they're $15 a piece. You know, that's already more than $50 value. And then there's three sets of keys that have some indeterminate value.
Yep.
And then the haunted trees, who cares, right?
I really feel like they could have done so much more with that.
But what's the point? I mean, it's like a chain tracker. Ultimately, 99% of them are going to end up in your box of decks, and you're never going to see it again. And it's fine.
Yeah, I mean, they're fine, right? I do think it's weird that they didn't put, like, even it could have been small, like
2014
haunted,
Star Champs.
Unhaunted. Okay. Well, I haven't deeply looked at the things yet because
I already lost my first one.
Well, wah-wah. You're in luck. We're having another one this week.
Oh, yeah. How about that?
You'll get another one.
So, all in all, the kit is fine, but I've already seen a few people say it, and I feel it coming. We said, you know, one of the things we talked about in the previous years, like, they aren't doing much. And, you know, like, special printed decks are something. But now they might be taking that ride a little too far, because that's what we're getting for store champs. And guess what? At Vault Tours, you get the same thing. There'll be a different special print, right? But it's the same thing.
Well, hold on. The battle tested. Well, they're definitely said they're reprinting, like, they're printing your deck with special, like, icons and stuff.
That's
like
the
badges.
First place thing.
Yeah.
I'm talking about their advertise. What are you gonna get? You're gonna get a pin.
Oh, some displays of stuff. Yeah.
So I'm gonna pin that says top eight, and how much you wanna bet, it doesn't say I got top eight at Roseville. It's just gonna be like from last year, I'd have four top eight pins that all look the same, or three, or however many I got. And
I thought they did say the pins are going to have locale on them.
No, everybody gets a locale pin. And then top eight gets a pin. Top four will get a pin. Second place will get a pin. And first place will get a pin, right? And each of those will be. But I'm saying, I bet you all the top eight pins, they'll look cool and all. But, you know, like, if you win two of them, you won't know which one's from which.
Well, that's fine. I'd rather have, like, custom border deck that says, like, of the Roseville Vault or something. Like,
do you think, now that's the question, are they going to print special decks for each event, or is this going to be the same thing where they're like, here's, you know, like, we have 10 vaults and each one gets, they haven't actually told us the numbers, each one gets 5 boxes printed for it, and they already did that print run and they're just sitting in the closet.
Well, I hope it says the name of the vault. That would be really cool. Make it more rare, make it more interesting.
Mm-hmm. More to it, because if it is basically the same thing as a store champ deck, but with the vault, so it's got a little more gold or shine or something on it, it is going to become disappointing.
Maybe. I don't know. I like the special treatment decks, and I think they definitely have an opportunity here to make it cool. But we'll see.
I think they're fine. I think I think they're a good addition, but when that's all you're getting, like, especially if it's tight, like, if you only get one, say, for the event, and you want to keep it, and it's crappy, because we all know custom name decks are often crappy. Store championship decks are going to be crappy. All of the ones from the first special print decks from the first run of GCs were crappy. Every single one of them was a garbage deck. Of course, they came from AOA, so they had an extra chance of crappiness. But, like, a special printed crappy deck isn't, like, even the ones from the Grand Championships, where there's only, like, 7 or 8 of them in the world, don't actually trade for that much money.
A little bit. Like, they do have some. It's not a lot. The Gamma ones.
These are going to... The Gamma ones are worth nothing. Nobody wants them.
Well, I bought one back in the day.
Well, sure.
That's not true. I'm told that these have all sorts of value.
They're maybe worth $10, right?
Yeah, I mean...
I'm talking a meaningful amount of money, which isn't that important to me, so I'm pulling a little Ewok here and representing the whole more than me, but it is going to get a little disappointing just to have, like, ultimately these decks are going to end up in my box, and then they're going to end up in a box, and I'm going to ship them to somebody as a joke because I just don't care about them, even though they have a special print, because they're not going to be meaningful for play.
Speaking of which, definitely Quick Draw mentioned on the latest cast what you did, Sheep. Did we mention that here?
I don't know what you're talking about. I don't believe anything.
So, but we can get into it. We don't got a lot for today, but we can definitely talk about what Sheep did.
Yeah, he definitely brought it up. So he definitely named you by name. So why don't you go ahead and tell our listeners how this played out, Sheep?
When you buy 3 decks from Sheep, what can you expect?
Well, he bought 4 decks.
I'm sorry, when you buy 4 decks from Sheep, what can I expect?
4 DT decks. 3 DT decks and an MM, actually. For not a very large amount of money, which is fine, because they're DT decks. And it was a $20-some total sale with shipping, and I chose to reinvest that money, right? I reinvested that into an important project for myself, which was dealing with my bulk collection. I was nearing 900 decks again, which is too many. So I took a 10 by 10 by 12 box or something at work, and I put every deck I could in there, which happened to be 220. Okay. It was 31 pounds of decks. That ships for less than $25.
Wow.
So I slapped QuickDraw's name on it and I shipped it.
So you padded the four decks.
Yeah, they were very well protected.
200 other decks.
That's right. I didn't have any bubble wrap, so I said 200 other decks is the best protection I can provide these four $5 DT decks.
Yeah.
And then this landed on his doorstep.
When it landed on the doorstep, the UPS guy ripped the box open.
So heavy.
And they ripped the opposite end from where the decks he wanted were. So we had to dig through that whole box.
I love it.
I think it would have been greater if you would have sent a GoPro with it. And we could have seen the look on his face when he got it. He was like, son of a, what the? I ordered four decks.
Someday, somebody will cause me enough grief where what I will ship them instead is they'll order like three decks. And what I'm going to do is open like 100 decks and then shuffle all the cards together.
Oh, gosh.
Oh.
Stick it in a 900 count box and ship that baby to them.
Yeah, they're all in there, I promise.
Yep. You enjoy that puzzle.
Oh, man.
The sales at the sheep store just went down by 75%.
Not that decks are selling right now.
I mean, from four decks in the last 3 months down to zero decks in the next 3 months is fine. I can live with this.
Because really, you just sold 200 some odd decks, right?
I did not sell. I shipped.
Well, you know.
There's a difference.
You know what? I may sound like a clown, but I'd actually had all those decks under a single tag, right? Because every time I'd open a deck and it would go into this thing I'd call my bulk box, I would just tag it and decks of Keyforge just bulk box. So I was able to give them a tagged list of basically every deck that was in that box.
Wow.
So as much of a clown and jerk as I might seem to be, I actually just gave him a giant pile of decks with a list.
Joke's on you until he comes back at you in Master Vault things and he's just scanning
each one.
None of them are scanned into this version of the Master Vault. They're all most of those are going to be previous to the new Master Vault.
How did that work? Do we know how that works? If it was previous to this Master Vault, can they just scan them in?
First person to scan it goes in. You remember there was that bunch of controversy when new Master Vault first came on and there were a bunch of stolen decks where people were scanning pictures from the internet and adding it to the wrong account.
I remember that, but I don't remember being, I wasn't affected by it, so. You can have my crappy 82 AOA deck. I'll live. But I was just wondering, like, if it was unscanned, yeah, you get it. But no
Amber Shards. No space dollars.
What a sad day. No space dollars. Yeah. So if you want an instant collection, buy four decks from Sheep. He will ship you 200.
That instant collection was actually listed for sale on a for sale site, and nobody expressed any interest. And that deck, and there's like up to 78s in that box. But that's where I'm kind of getting with special print decks. Even if I open a 78 or 80 special print deck and I play it twice, after that, it just doesn't matter. It's not good enough to make the Archon list. It's not bad enough to make the weird things. And maybe by some awesome chance, it's adaptive worthy. Every deck's adaptive worthy, but then who cares if it's special print because you only play that junk online.
What's adaptive?
Yeah. I mean, you can play adaptive at your local if you wanted.
It's one of those formats that people still like.
What? That's a format in Keyforge?
Like Triad, man. It died.
Never heard of it.
Triad's dead, Survival, all the good formats, and then adaptive.
The only good format that you had mentioned right there was survive, was three deck survival, but even then I wouldn't want to survive the way it sits right now. I would not want to play three deck survival because I don't have one good deck. Now I gotta find two other shit decks to play along with my other crap.
You need to step up your crappy deck collecting. I have presented the next door championship. I think I'm running is going to be two deck sealed survival.
I don't mind two deck sealed survival. Even three deck sealed survival is fine.
Two if you want to get it done in a reasonable amount of time.
Well, not for a store championship.
Yeah, well, that's what I'm saying. Store championship, 23rd, Sanctum Gaming of Racine. That's what I think we're running.
Is that a Sunday? No, it's a Saturday.
That's a Saturday.
I cannot attend.
Boo.
I'm sorry. Well, you put on a Saturday. Good work. Got things to do.
Yeah, because we're having a party at my house afterwards.
Oh, is that the Port and Malort party?
Yeah, Port Malort night.
Yeah, that's why I'm skipping that one. Because he's bringing Malort. And I said, I'll pass.
I will bring Malort on Tuesday night. And you will drink with us.
I will not.
You will.
You can't make me.
I can too.
It's horrible. I think that's what I got to do. I think I need to talk to some of my Illinois friends, and I need to get a bottle of Malort so that we can...
I have it! We're ready to go!
But you're not coming to a vault tour!
You can have my bottle.
Okay. Because I think we need to get Mr. Drazcore into Malort.
Sydney?
I've had Malort, yeah.
Sydney's bringing
it. Malort?
Oh, worried.
Okay. Never mind.
Yeah, I actually have Malort here. I've got those little sample bottles.
I'm sure it's just as bad by you as it is everywhere else.
Well, no, I brought these back from Chicago, actually, because I got some of the little sample bottles. Like, we tried
it's so bad they were just giving it away, huh?
Well, we were at the distillery. Like, we, not
actually
the actual
distill
distillery.
That isn't just, like, the employees pissing in a bucket.
I mean, they tell you.
It was the Chicago River. They just bottled it.
They tell you it's distilled Chicago River, actually. So it's still distilled. So,
they don't actually ferment it. That's
be
just
careful.
Chicago River.
You might find a needle or a gun in either one.
They distill it just to take off the stuff that'll actually kill you.
Oh,
and what's left is more lard.
This will just give you the shivers, but it won't kill you. You might go blind in one eye. But, you know, that's about it. So,
all right. So what? We were talking about store championships.
So
what do you get to play tomorrow, Draz?
So tomorrow we have our sealed event. So
what is your package for that?
What's the package? Well, we're going to do a three deck sealed. When everybody gets there, I'm going to take a pulse check to see if folks want to do
unified
true sealed or blasphemic sealed.
Yeah.
If there's folks there that are like, I really want to do, you know, Alliance, then that's fine. We could do that. But I suspect we'll have folks that all vote to do True Sealed. So,
back in the day, I was so okay with, you know, the whole Sealed Alliance thing. I'm like, it's fine. It's okay.
I'm okay with it. I'm not like, yeah.
After playing it so many times, you're like, dude, I don't want to do this. I want to pick one. Like,
beautiful part of Keyforge where you just open a deck and play it.
Well, it's just
let's do some of that.
It's the whole point of where I think you said it, where you're like, if this was if this was just a sealed event, it would do okay. But it's because it's Sealed Alliance, it's not going to do much. And like, it definitely feels that way. Like, it makes good decks even better, and then it makes your two junk that you've pulled even worse, because like junk plus junk, you know, like I said, shit plus shit still equals shit. But if you pulled something halfway decent and then an okay pod somewhere along the way, it was like, oh, my good deck just became better.
Yeah.
Like, it's like the rich get richer and the bottom people just stay at the bottom.
That's go over and listen to Sloppy. They did it. They did the math. It widens the field.
Widens the field. How so?
In average, using SAS, which isn't perfect, but it's a way to metricize stats, it widens the distribution of SAS across decks.
So it makes it more even or makes
no,
it less?
No, makes it less even.
More likely that you'll have outliers.
Right.
That, makes sense. That are
junkier than the average.
Importantly, strong outliers, right?
Yeah.
Don't remember the numbers, but it was like something like it was 64 or something if you just played single deck with an average spread of 4 or something was like your single standard deviation. And then with Alliance, it went up to 68, but it was also a 6-point standard deviation.
Mm. Right.
So it, that theory that it would make a tighter spike doesn't work out in the practice numbers they did. Which I'd said with just gut feeling, but nobody listens to me, which is okay. It's fine. Like, some people like it, some people like choice. They can have it. You guys know I'm not for it. We also have the same thing, which is we run ours on Tuesday. We have 3-deck, but one of our decks that you're getting in your 3-deck package is one of the store named decks. Right? They have 12. So as long as we don't get more than 12 players, we're okay.
This is the one week we're going to have 13.
Yeah. Well, then I'll give up my deck because that's how that goes.
Yeah.
So,
they're all grim.
So, there's actually, I guess this is a good problem to have. So, in my area, there's quite a few store championships, which means, which is a little bit of a challenge because folks can't necessarily go to all of them. So, like, for example, today,
bad thing.
Oh, no, it's good for the game. It's just there's folks in Jersey who in the past have sometimes come to the events that I run. But they ran their event today. So I think it's less likely that folks are going to, you know, the following day drive all the way down to Westchester, Pennsylvania, to play.
Is this not
today.
A bunch of the same crowd that was at least 3 different vaults last year? They clearly have shown some stupid Keyforge dedication.
This is true. They could. I mean, I wasn't able to go up there today. I kind of wanted to, but I had stuff going on. So we'll see. We'll see. And then there's another one just an hour west of me that's playing on Tuesday. And then downtown Philadelphia, I actually didn't realize this one place even really has a Keyforge stuff going on, but they scheduled like the same time as my event. I was like, come on, dudes, what the heck? my Archon event. So
that is nice this time.
Yeah.
With these store championships. And how small or tight our current community is, we were able to schedule 1, 2, 3, 4 different stores or something and made sure we didn't schedule on top of each other. Where I remember Bingo Bang Bang Mat store championships, like a bunch of those were on top of each other. And it was like, you got to be kidding me, right? Yeah. It's like, everybody had them at the same time.
Yep. Yeah, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 stores within, I'll say, a 2-hour radius of me.
Fun story, I have one of each. Bingo Bang Bang, Matt.
I have given away most of those, too.
I gave away a lot of them, because I had a few extra, I think, what was it? Was it first, second, then top 4?
Sure.
Or did they have a 3rd and 4th place? I don't remember. I had one of each at one point.
No, it was just top 4. I think there was top 8s on that too.
No, there wasn't. That was just Primes. Primes had the top 8. Remember. They had one mat and then they had Nizek for the winner. But
Yeah.
And nobody wanted the Nizek mat. Everyone wanted the Reaper mat.
That is not true at all.
Who wanted the Nizek mat?
I don't have it, even though I won them because people wanted them. I still got Stinking Grim Reaper, Matt.
That is, the Nizek mat is the one of the few I don't have, actually.
And I'm okay with that. I like the Grim Reaper mat way better than the Nizek mat.
Yeah, well,
I still play with it to this day. Still play with it to this day. I don't see a lot of Grim Reaper mats. Of course, I don't see a lot of Nizek mats either.
Whatever mat you got in Rock is fine. It doesn't really matter.
It does matter. It always matters.
Now, I'm scrolling around the map here, and I'm just taking in what we have in the United States here. I'm taking in the locations of all these various store champs.
And that was Josh who set that up, right? The map?
Yes.
The map? Yep.
Yes.
So good job. We have somewhat of a store locator.
Yep.
Good.
This is a good thing. Nicely done, sir. But if you were to overlay the vaults on top of this, it overall, I think it makes a lot of sense. So the north,
you wanna link that in the chat here, so I don't have to keep looking for it.
I did. Take a look at the chat.
Good job.
It's there. Yeah. It's already there.
You're
so,
good at this.
You could see, hey, there's a whole clumping between DC and I'll call it Boston, even though there aren't any in Boston, but Connecticut, New York, New Jersey, three in Pennsylvania, one in Maryland. So good clumping through there. So putting a vault in Baltimore makes a lot of sense. Then north of that, there's a bunch in Southern Canada and whatnot. So Rochester makes some sense in terms of, hey, if you're going to do it in the U.S., those are all very drivable to Rochester. And then you can still, pull stuff from folks from, the East Coast as well. So that makes a lot of sense. The Midwest, you could have done something in Midwest, certainly. But, Minneapolis is obviously they're going to do because that's where they are. But you could have even argued, like, hey, let's run one in Cleveland or something. I guess Indy is the national, so that makes a lot of sense. That's right in the midst of all these. Then on the West Coast,
hey, look, there's a bunch near Seattle.
Yeah, there's a bunch in Seattle that didn't work out, obviously. Although, I think the numbers were low because they announced that one. But still,
nobody wants to go to Seattle.
Flights were actually expensive. I couldn't do it, but I was looking at flights, and it was kind of expensive to Seattle.
Are flights always expensive to Seattle, or is that just me being crazy?
I don't know, but they're way cheaper to San Francisco. Now in theory, you could have done something like San Francisco area, LA, or San Diego. In theory, but Las Vegas, hey, that draws from those areas. So if you put a big circle between San Diego, San Francisco, Portland, Seattle, Vancouver, and then to the right, Denver and Colorado Springs. That gets
weird
you to Vegas.
Weird story, so, not a so single vault in Phoenix.
Phoenix, yeah. Well, there's no...
I'm sorry, Nevada. My bad, Nevada.
Sure,
bad.
Sure, but it's
not
center.
A single anything in Nevada.
Yeah, I mean, Nevada's basically... Yeah, Las Vegas, Reno, right? There's a lot of empty space there. So that makes sense. Now, Texas, all you've got is the vault in Houston, or excuse me, the store champs in Houston. So just purely looking at this, putting a vault in Texas doesn't 100% make sense. I think this is the one that if you just use this information to try to...
This is pretty dope. I got to say, this is a nice little setup here. I didn't realize that you could literally click on the little vault thing and it takes, well, for most of them anyways, not all of them.
For the U.S. vault.
Probably for the ones you could find, right, if they had it on here. They take you, like, here's the game store. Here's here's what they're charging, That's kind of dope.
I'm looking at this map. Dallas, which I know there's players, there's nothing. Salt Lake City, there's nothing. And then, which is only... It only clues off to those of us who live in the Midwest, but then Duluth, Minnesota has a store championship. And that's like out there in the middle of friggin' nowhere. There's nothing. There is nothing.
There's lots
Duluth.
In Duluth.
The only reason I know about Duluth is because whenever you play like a train board game, they always have a stop in Duluth.
because I guess in that's olden where, times,
that's where all the coal comes in from the north.
Yeah. Sure. Yeah, I guess, sure. You know.
It's, I mean, like, yes, it definitely, Duluth is a fairly big city, and Superior's right there.
Mm-hmm.
So there is a fair population, but it is nowhere near the population density that there is in, when you're just looking and you scroll out on this map a little bit, and, you know, as you scroll out, it, you know, sets the size of towns, and you're here at this Dallas, Kansas City, Albuquerque, Phoenix, Salt Lake, sized things, Orlando, Miami, Tampa, New Orleans.
Yeah.
And none of those have anything. That Duluth.
Yeah. And there's nothing in Florida. So there was some vocal folks, some of whom are in our chat right now, asking about, hey, what the heck? Why not the Southeast, right? Atlanta would be a great spot. Now if you look, there's nothing in Florida.
Star championships.
Well, so
Florida's icky. It's okay to not have things in Florida.
I agree.
There's a lot of people there, right?
Okay. Yeah.
So there's a big opportunity.
A lot of people in Texas. No, it doesn't mean we should be going there either.
There's a lot of old people in Florida.
Let's ignore, you know, all sorts of things. So
There's old people in Florida.
So let's look. Yeah, my grandmother's down there right now.
Exactly. That's where people go to die.
Old people are allowed to play Keyforge.
This is true. This is true.
They haven't kicked me out yet.
I was just gonna say. This is why we let Dad play. So, all right. Well, let's look here. So we've got one in Atlanta. We've got one in, what town is this even in South Carolina? What? Anderson? Yeah.
Raleigh?
So it's. Well, there's Anderson in South Carolina, which is interesting.
South Carolina.
You've got a store in Raleigh, and then you've got one in Jacksonville, North Carolina.
Outside of Greenville.
So in theory, if you wanted to hit a central point between these, if you just assume these are the hot spots, doing something like Charlotte could make sense. Now there's no store champ in Charlotte, so I don't know if there's a Charlotte scene, but somewhere through that strip.
If they should all be in the Midwest. Like, if we're going by this, you put one in Vegas, because that covers most of the West Coast, and Denver could easily get in there. Denver could easily get to Nevada. Everything else, like, you should have one in Philly.
And Baltimore's close enough. I mean, it's
one in, like, Ohio. Yeah. Which I guess Indiana, you got star champs. Indiana, you have, you know, whatever.
In Gen Con.
Yeah. Gen Con in Indiana. And then, yeah, like it should all be East Coast stuff.
And it should be Chicago and not Minneapolis, but.
But yeah, they're going to.
Why not both?
Well, so what it really comes down to is you need a store that will sit 100 plus players. And is willing to play the game that they got to play to run the Vault Tour, because it's either costing the store something or they're making some sort of agreement about sales and shares. I mean, I don't actually have this agreement. I've never seen what the newest Vault looks like, but it's not free, right? It's costing them something, whether it is just time and space. But you have to have a big enough venue, and you have to be willing to give it up for Keyforge for a 3-day event, not a 1-day event, a 3-day event. And those two things are not actually that easy to come by.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. Like, I don't know that I have, like, have I ever been at a store that could house that many folks? Like, I'm trying to even think, right? Like,
there used to be one in Chicago, started with a P. They ran Dark Moon Fairs for the Wild Card game. They were also the place that was doing those events.
Mm-hmm.
Their store was huge.
Yeah. Yeah, I think, there's definitely, in the chat, folks are mentioning Nashville in Tennessee as a central spot, which...
Which it could be. I don't know. That feels like it might be far from like Raleigh.
Tennessee is tough to fly into.
Is it? I mean, I would love to visit Nashville. I have not.
I've been there, and it. So I went to Nashville. I remember like the cost because when I worked for AutoClore, I had to book my own flights. And every time we had to go to Nashville, I had to go to Nashville twice. And it's always you had to get a connecting flight. So typically what would happen is you would fly from, for me anyways, and I'm sure it's a little different, it would be from Milwaukee to Chicago, then get it on another plane from Chicago, and I think one time I stopped in Charlotte, and one time I was in Georgia. I was in Atlanta. Mm. And then you went to Nashville.
That you can't go from Chicago to Nashville? That seems strange.
No, I always had to either go to... Well, again, it was only the twice, but I had to one time go to Charlotte and one time go to Atlanta. Now, the second time when I went there, I had to go to Atlanta, and I was supposed to connect from Atlanta to Nashville, but there was a change, so then I had to go from Atlanta to North Carolina and then North Carolina to Tennessee. It was just a pain, and I don't know if that's just has something to do with their airport, but it was a pain.
I mean, it's a... popular
man travel product, it doesn't matter, travel sucks to some extent, and then there's some truth that the bigger the airport you get, which is cheaper for travel, then generally the venues outside of it are more expensive,
yeah,
because everybody's looking for them because they're like, oh, the travel's cheap,
right? Which
it you get busted one way or the other, right? It's yeah, just how it is.
I don't know. I'm looking at Raleigh to Nashville. That is over 8-hour drive. So I don't know if that, I don't know if Nashville is the best if you want to draw folks from North Carolina, right? If I put Jacksonville, North Carolina, it's going to be even further. Let's see here, Jack.
I'm not sure, but also don't let, I remember because I had one of the guys, he was from there, and he was like, yeah,
10 hours.
You can't be here after dark, and you can't be there after dark. I don't know.
Well, I mean, every city has
every
that, right?
City
I mean,
has that.
When we were in Philly, and X-Ray ended up in West Philly.
X-Ray.
like
X-rays.
Somebody got arrested and tased in front of him. I was like, dude, why are you in West Philly? Like,
X-Ray is
not
number one.
Not
you would think you X-Ray, of all people, has watched The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. number two, X-Ray is a different breed of dumb, right? Like, yeah, he's just like, I don't know how he finds himself.
He's your gold standard American dumb.
Literally, like, that man finds himself in the weirdest situations that you could possibly find yourself in.
When if we ever leave this country, I'm bringing him because he makes me look good.
Yeah,
no. Well, makes me look like. Like, this is what you think when you think American.
It's X-Ray. Like, he's just his goofy ass face is just in the dictionary. Like, it's just like this again. The situation this man finds himself in. I don't even know how it's possible that he finds himself in all of these situations. Like, it's just I don't even understand how you could be so traditionally American in all the wrong ways.
But what?
Like,
that's not
come
it.
On. X-Ray's a good guy. We just like to.
Is he? We don't know.
He is. I mean, as far as we know.
I like X-Ray fine. Yes. Okay. So we're totally off topic. You never cut us off at a half an hour. Are we talking about something useful?
No,
well,
we're not.
Let's look at.
We're
let's look at up. Other areas.
And that's all the time
with,
we have this week.
Well, come on.
Yeah. Thanks for listening to Help from Future Self.
We did this show. We sat here and looked at a map before and said, these are the places that you should go because of population centers. Like, go back and listen. Like, this is.
Well, how about what?
I mean, like, there's, I really don't know what to talk about without having the other guys. It makes us not want to do our Mars cards because it'll fall a little flat without our master number generator.
Yep.
And our walk bot. So we didn't want to do that. KeyForge News, there's not.
A little slow.
Since
a little
the last
slow.
Time, right? And it's like, we already shit talked what we can shit talk.
I don't.
We got
some
championships. They're okay. Yeah, we're excited to have them. People are putting them on. There are some attendance numbers. We have reserved the shit talking playstyle not being here for it.
That's fine.
Yeah, because it really doesn't matter. Who cares? Actually, in some ways, is awesome because now there's just you don't have to run 2.0. You can run whatever you want because you're running on whatever software you want.
Well, even so, what they shipped out, the cheat sheet that talks about how to run the tournament, it had both. It had both Swiss and 2.0 listed. So they definitely.
In other news, somebody's trying to sell the Dune popcorn bucket for $70.
Nice.
Huh? If you wanted a Dune popcorn bucket,
like from what they went to like a Regal Cinema and got a popcorn bucket for $27 that says Dune 2 on
have
it.
Have you not? Do you live under rocks?
I mean,
he lives in Philadelphia.
I live near trees, which sheep doesn't
have,
like.
Have
sheep,
you not
sheep like
seen?
Rocks.
Dude, I saw your trees. Your trees are just fine.
Just fine.
Have you not seen the Dune?
Them down to nothing.
That's true.
I'm gonna guess you haven't seen the Dune popcorn bucket. There
no, I
There's
have not.
The Dune popcorn right, bucket.
Yep. Oh, it's like a sandworm.
But that's gonna do it for this week, guys.
I'm definitely putting that on my lap.
Yeah. And so are other people. Anyways, just not in the way you're thinking. Go attend a Star Championship. Have some fun. Let us know what decks you crack. I'm interested to see. I do want me a battle tested deck.
Yeah,
I am down to own a few battle tested decks.
I can't guarantee that they're not going to end up in the shredder bin.
I almost guaranteed they will.
All right. Well, shredder. Well, they're GR decks though. You had a good shot here of pulling some fire.
Yeah, but people will be extra pissed if we shred them.
Yeah,
which makes it more fun.
All so the more reason to do it, right?
So let's shred them.
Of course, Z and I did fail. We were supposed to shred Volt what?
Master.
Volt. Yeah, whatever those junk decks were. We were supposed to shred those last year, and we never did.
No, we were supposed to. Well, somebody. Not
somebody
pointing
kept freaking.
Not pointing any elbows here, but somebody got their tizzy in a tizzy.
In a tangle. At Worlds, I was pretty tizzle-tanged. Yep, you are right.
And we didn't even run Shredder Worlds.
Somebody forgot the prize. Don't put this on me.
You left it at your house.
Oh, I've never even seen it.
What do you mean? It's at your house right now.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, I handed it. I handed it to you when I was like, I might have forgotten this, and I just gave it to you. But that's going to do it for us this week. Make sure you go attend your events. Make sure the stores know we're still around. Not only that, we got a vault tour coming up. Yeah.
Plane tickets got cheap yet?
We are like 3 weeks away, I want to say. Let's see. One.
I got a pretty good price.
Two, three, 4 weeks away? We'll call it 4 weeks away. We're a month out, boys, from 2024 vault tour.
Yep, 4 weeks. Yeah,
I am excited to go pay a bunch of money to lose.
Prices are still high, and it's $330 to fly Frontier to Vegas.
Ooh, damn!
Oh, the Vegas ones. Oh, I haven't.
Oh,
Vegas. Checked on the Vegas.
Yeah, Vegas. I don't know what it is. Vegas is stupid expensive right now for that week. All right, now I gotta look at.
All right. So with that being said, thank you all for joining us for our crazy, strange ramblings for this week. I'll be doing my best to get both these episodes out. If you haven't listened to the last one, go to listen to the last one before you listen to this one. Or it's too late. Either or. It really doesn't matter. We just ramble here. It's like, whose line is it anyway? Where everything's made up and the points don't matter. Thanks for listening.
Happy forging, everyone.